Welcome to my new video. In this video I'm going to show you how to master the Automation Anywhere challenge in UiPath with Inject JavaScript. Click on Download CSV to download the input file. I've already downloaded it and the file looks like this. We have 10 columns and 7 rows. We want to enter the contents of this file into the browser. The content of each column should be entered in a specific field in the browser. These are the fields that should be filled out. We also have a button below which should be clicked after entering a complete line. There are also radio buttons and checkboxes. The content of the offers discounts column is always yes or no. If it is yes, then the radio button yes should be clicked, otherwise the radio button no should be clicked. The content of the column non-disclosure on file is always yes or no. If it is yes, then the checkbox should be checked, otherwise the checkbox should not be checked. And at the end, when the line has been completely entered, the register button should be clicked. I will first read out this CSV file and convert it to JSON string so that we can solve the task more easily. Copy the path of the CSV file. Add a read CSV activity. Enter the path. Create a variable for the output. This is of the type, data table. Create another variable of the type string. For example, name the variable, JSONString. Create another variable with the name, JSONConvert. The type for this variable is JSONConvert. Add an assign activity. Write the following in this activity. This instruction converts the data table variable into JSON string. Add an open browser activity. Enter the link of the page here. We can copy this from the browser. I included the link in the video description. Under browser type, you can select the browser. I will use Chrome. Now we want to write the code somewhere, so let's create a text file. Rename the file to code.js. Click Yes to save the text file as a JavaScript file. As you can see, the file is now a JavaScript file. Copy the path of the JavaScript file. Add an inject JS script activity. Enter the path. Under input parameter, we can enter the input variables that should be used in the code, if we have any. In our task, we need the table that we converted into JSON string, so we enter this variable here. Now we can write the JavaScript code. To do this, click on Edit to edit the file. We write element first, and then the input variable. It's JSON string. Now we convert the string to JSON object with this statement. Now let's create a loop for this JSON object. In this loop, we write the following statement. This statement contains several parts. GetElementById, the ID of the element from the browser should be entered here. The I is the counter of the loop and the name of the column should be entered at the end. I'll show you now how to get the ID. Go to the browser and click the mouse, right click, then click on inspect. You can see the ID here when you click on the element, for example the customer name field. Here on the right side you can see the ID for this field. We should then enter this in our code. Here we have the name of the column from the CSV file that is to be entered in this field. The instruction is now ready. As already mentioned, the code searches for the field in the browser using the ID and enters the content of the company name column there. I copy this instruction and paste it again for all columns. I delete the ID and name of the column from each row so we can fill in the correct data. I go line by line. I look for the element in the browser, take the ID and enter this in the code. Then I enter the name of the column back into the code. Now all fields are ready. But we still have a column for radio buttons and a column for checkboxes. For this we need an if statement. If the content is yes, the yes radio button should be clicked, otherwise the no button should be clicked. We also check the content of the checkbox. If the content is equal to yes, then the checkbox is checked, otherwise it is not checked. At the end, the register button should be clicked. I read the ID from the browser. It's submit underscore button. Then we use the click function so that this button is clicked. Our code is now ready. I'll briefly explain the code again. We have a function with an input parameter. This is JSONString. We convert the string to object. Then we have a loop for this object. With each iteration of the loop, the fields are identified by the ID and filled out. The content comes from the JSON object, our original CSV file. The radio buttons check whether yes or no. The checkbox also checks whether yes or no. And with each iteration of the loop, the button register is clicked. Save the file and close it. I close the browser. Now the code can be executed. We have a mistake. This CSV file is open, so there is a problem. I close the file and run the code again. We didn't see anything because the code was very fast. You can already see that it took less than 1 second to fill out the fields. It was 100% correct, which means that all fields were filled incorrectly. I will start the code again and see how long it will take to execute because this is always different. This time it took longer, but it was still very fast again. Less than 1 second, this is the advantage of JavaScript compared to the standard activities of UiPath, such as for each row and set text etc. I look forward to your feedback and am curious if you have ever solved the problem and how long did it take with you. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel to see my new videos.